I'm here with Adam on the Attunity booth. Adam, you guys are focused on GDPR compliance.
Indeed we are.
What are you guys up to?
Okay, so we're very much focused around GDPR compliance for SAP customers.
Right.
It's a serious concern to SAP customers is how they're going to achieve GDPR compliance in their production systems. There are a number of solutions out there, but they are difficult and lengthy to implement.
Right.
The key thing here is that SAP customers think that the GDPR requirements actually require them to delete data from their SAP systems, and this isn't the case. They just need to anonymize it. So the right to be forgotten means I cannot identify you in the system. And that's where we come in. We've created a very, very simple tool that can be deployed in an SAP environment to anonymize business partners, vendors, customers, employees, and make it nice and easy.
So if I'm a utility and oil and gas customer, and I ring up and say, hey, whatever, EDF, Eon, you name it, forget me, they use your software to anonymize my data, so for all intents and purposes, yes, I cannot be identified again.
Yes. So, the important thing here is if you phoned up and said that, first of all, they've got to identify you.
Yes.
And they've got to find you in the system. And our solution will help them do that. They can actually create a policy that will enable them to identify particular individuals based upon name, circumstance, where they live, postcode, and they can really track down that data. And then they can decide how they want to anonymize it. And that's it. Nice and simple.
Now, when we were chatting yesterday, one of the fascinating things you brought up was most oil and gas companies, or most companies in all industries, will have a subset of the production data for test systems or training systems. So potentially my data is over there as well.
Yes.
So that's a feature for GDPR.
Absolutely. This is something that SAP, a lot of SAP organizations that we talk to, miss. And that is that when you set up an SAP system, you do need data. You need it for training, for development, for testing, for QA reasons. And that is often created by copying the full production data.
You want the real stuff, right?
Yep. So you just copy it and everybody's happy, away you go. But it's not GDPR compliant. The restrictions in your non-production environments are much less than your production environment. Your developers can go anywhere and look at any data. You're just absolutely in breach of GDPR straight away. So when we mention this to GDPR teams and SAP customers, they often sort of look at you as if this light bulb has gone off.
Yesterday when I was chatting, I was like, ding, oh God, never even, no, it's not my words, but I was like, I never even thought of that.
Right? Yeah, and there's usually a little bit of bad language that goes on, and then we have a conversation. And our standard gold client solution is designed to, first of all, help you manage the architecture in your SAP environment, shrink it, but also, as we do that, as we give you the ability to copy the data you want when you need it, we can scramble it. And it's in use by a number of different utilities in Portugal, I'm just trying to think, in South America, in the UK. There are organizations that are using our software to be GDPR compliant in their non-production environment.
And also, obviously, with your system, if I do ring up and say, forget me, you're able to, using your software, that person's able to receive a report to say, well, this is what we've done for compliance.
Yep, we can actually provide that information about what we've scrambled and where.
Hey, thank you very much.
Thank you.